Do not fake tan without watching this video. Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm gonna talk to you about something that I consider myself quite the expert in as a extremely ghostly, almost invisible, see-through, very pale girl. I wanted to talk to you guys about something I do all the time, which is fake tan. Let's begin by stating the obvious. I am currently not super dark. Why? Because I just fake tanned and I'm using a product, which I'm going to talk about at length because I adore it, that does not have an indicator on it, meaning I will not look dark until this tan is fully developed. But I am a mother of a 6-month-old. When I have filming time, I have filming time, and that's what I'm going to do. So this is my arsenal of fake tanning products. Okay, let's start off with the absolute number one essential: prepping the skin. The first thing you need to know is that you have to exfoliate. I know it's really annoying, I know nobody likes to do it, but do yourself a favor, get a scrub, something that's really easy that you can take in the shower, scrub down, and just be done with it. You don't have to take a bubble bath and do all this kind of stuff. Just take a scrub, like this coffee scrub. This one is Plush Body. This is a new one that I haven't opened yet, but I've already gone through one of this. It's the Cocoa and Gold 24 Karat Coffee Scrub. It has 24 karat gold flakes, brown sugar, sea salt, jojoba essential oil, coconut essential oil, coconut fruit, purified water, and roasted and ground coffee. Very important to note, you cannot scrub and use this and then fake tan. So, hear me out. I know that's annoying, but this has oils in it. Oils are going to block the penetration of whatever fake tan you put on top. So my recommendation, say it's a Friday night, take a shower, scrub your body, okay? And do this the day before. On Saturday, wake up, take another shower, do not moisturize, and then apply your fake tan. I'm sorry if you can hear my dogs barking. Hey, the garbage men are here. Do your scrub, check the ingredients in whatever scrub you're using. It doesn't matter which one you use, but check the ingredients for anything that says oil. If it says oil, then you need to shower that off before you put your fake tan on, okay? So scrub, 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 elbows, knees, all that kind of stuff. The next day you wake up, you shower, you do not put on moisturizer, and you put on your favorite fake tanner, okay? Now I'm gonna talk about how you put the fake tan on, and then I'll go into what my favorite fake tan is. So you have to use a mint, okay? Just splurge for it. You can use it multiple times over if you take good care of it. It will last you at least a year, in my opinion. I've been fake tanning for years, and I buy probably one new mint a year. And the important thing to do is, within the same day that you have fake tanned, wash it. Just wash it under the sink, put a little bit of your hand soap on it, rub it through and wash it. The longer you wait, the more it's gonna stain. So I would not recommend doing it right after you fake tan, because you're going to wash off all the fake tan from your hands. So, or you can ask your boyfriend or your roommate or your husband to wash it for you. That's another option. So use a mitt. The next thing I'm gonna talk about is my favorite fake tanners. My favorite at the moment is the Saint Tropez Natural Glowing Skin Bronzing Water Mousse. I love this because it doesn't have a, it doesn't have like any kind of like rub off, what's it called? The indicator. So you can fake tan and it doesn't show up on your skin. You can wear white clothes like I'm wearing. I just fake tanned and I'm wearing white clothes. So it's the bomb, okay? The other thing I really like about this one is this is the only one in the history of all the ones I've tried, and I'm about to show you all the ones I've tried, that does not make you smell ripe when it develops. I don't smell any different. If anything, I smell a little bit better than I did before. I smell kind of coconutty. It's really nice. It doesn't make you smell gross. It doesn't smell like fake tan. You can go to work and it's not offensive. Nobody can sit there and tell that you are wearing, you know, that you're probably due for a shower because your tan has been on for 8 hours and you need to wash it off. So this is really, really nice. And I can put this on in about the same time it takes me to put on body moisturizer. So I get out of the shower, I put this on, done. Nothing on top, no moisturizer, go about your day. Take a shower that night if you feel like it, but you don't really smell gross or feel, you know, like you don't feel gross after putting this one on. It's really nice. And I'll tell you about how to maintain your tan in a little bit. My second favorite, this was recently dethroned by this one. This one is not as dark, but I can put it on more carefree. It doesn't streak. I get this natural looking golden tan. So I could do this once or twice a week if I want to, and it's really no big deal. This one is more involved because it's that kind of classic dark bronzy indicator tan that you need to really kind of like spread on and smooth out with your glove, with your mitt. This is the 2-Hour Express Deluxe Bronzing Mousse from Loving Tan in the shade Dark, and this is thebomb.com. I know that Saint Tropez has come out with an ultra dark, which I really want to try. And I know Loving Tan has an ultra dark, but that is the 8-hour version. This one you can wash off in 2 hours. So if you're a procrastinator like me and you forget to tan and you want to do that deep dark tan, like maybe like a once a month thing, if you're kind of using this as your maintenance, or once every couple weeks or something, you can put this on at like 8 o'clock at night, and then by the time you go to bed, you can shower it off and you don't have to ruin your sheets or anything like that. The third favorite that I have, nobody really talks about this one. This is the one that probably smells the least offensive other than this one. This one doesn't smell like anything while it's developing. But this one is the Tarte Brazilian Skin Rejuvenating Maracuja Self-Tanner. Great for dry skin, doesn't dry your skin out, smells great. It actually comes out in a different formulation. It's kind of like a gel, and I still use a mitt, and I love the smell of this. Even when I'm a little bit ripe, I still like the smell of this. It is it natural? It has vitamin C and essential fatty acids. I never get streaky with this. I never have an issue with this. It's not the darkest tan, but it is fairly dark. I love this. I'm almost out and I definitely will repurchase it, which is saying something considering I have about 45 self-tanners. So these are two that I would holy grail 100% repurchase, along with this one. I love those three. Those are my top three. Wouldn't buy any others, but I will talk about the other ones that I do have. I do have the self-tan dark from Saint Tropez. This is good. I think Loving Tan is a little bit better because it's 2 hours and this is 8 hours. The Vita Liberata Luxury Tan, 2 to 3 week tan. It's only 2 to 3 weeks if you follow their instructions, which involves reapplying the tanner like a day or two later. Sorry, but I just cannot be bothered for something like that. That it says for longest lasting tan, apply 3 times, leaving each application to develop for 3 to 24 hours. I'm sorry, but I do not have a 3-day commitment for anything, let alone a self tan. Also, I found that this wore off a little bit patchy. For natural glow, like gradual tanners, I really like this one from First Aid Beauty. This one says it's an odorless face formula for face and body. However, I do find that I smell ripe after using this. I mean, it's just unavoidable. I also smell ripe after using this, but they both are very nice streak-free formulas. I don't even use a mitt with this. It doesn't make my palms turn orange. So this one is the self-tan, Gradual Tan Classic Everyday Mousse. This is cool because it's a gradual tanner in a mousse formulation. So I can put this on after I shower and it's fine. This one is kind of like a gel. No, this is not a gel. What am I talking about? I'm thinking of the Tarte one. This is a lotion and it's odorless because it doesn't smell like anything when you put it on, but it's not odorless in the sense that you do, if you went like that after about probably a few hours, you could probably tell that you had put on a gradual tanner. However, it's very inoffensive. I do think you could still go to work in a professional environment and not give yourself away. So that is my favorite self-tanner collection doodad. How do you maintain your tan? Okay, this is very important. Moisturize, moisturize, moisturize. However, what do you moisturize with? A lot of products, and I'm not sure what ingredient it is. If I can find that information out, I will update you guys on my channel. But there are certain ingredients in moisturizers that will break down fake tan, and that may be what makes you go patchy. Not necessarily the product, although I've tried whatever I can, this one goes patchy. So you need to buy a moisturizer. I know it's annoying, but you need to buy a moisturizer that is made to maintain self-tan formulations. So for me, I really like this one. It's by Saint Tropez. It's the Prep and Maintain Tan Enhancing Moisturizer. It smells really nice. I can just slap it on. It also gives you kind of like a nice little sheen. I'll put some on. No, I can't put some on. I just self-tanned. Okay. gives you a really nice little sheen kind of on your skin. So it just makes you look really hydrated, really fresh, really glowy. I love it. It smells super good. Make sure that you're choosing a product that is made to maintain self-tans. Okay, that is it. I've been rambling for long enough. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you found it helpful, please give the video a like, rate it down below. And if you're new to my channel, hi, my name's Christina. I make videos a couple times a week. I'm a full-time anesthesiologist, new mom, and I live in Texas. So thank you for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.